You know, there's some. A lot of people don't get sense for this life. What are you telling me, YouTube? It's your boy Jubemi in HD. Oluwa Jubemi, aka fattest guy ever living. You understand me? Today, my first video things. Clap for me.
Please clap.
But yeah. That I'll be telling you a story time video, you know, a story of my water bottle, you know. Story. Once upon a time, believe it or not, this whole thing caused by a water bottle. Something as small as this. Like, story takes place when I was still in secondary school in Nigeria. You know, for my Nigerians, I'll assume you know this school, Loyola Jesuit College or LJC, Loyola. They called it local jail for children. So, you get that school was just, you know, if you find normal person. Okay, understand this school, I said you can find bully you, psychopath too. You find you know, it's disappointing. That's I'll tell you the truth, but that's for another day. I don't want to veer off into another topic, you know. That's not why I'm here. I was in SS1 or say for my Americans, 8th grade, or for my UK guys, year 9, I guess. Yeah, I was about to turn 16. Oh, I was turning 16. I can't even remember like that. But then, yeah, we're resuming school. And before resuming school, they always give us this list, right? For packing. Fine. Honestly, this bad water bottle. Because I'm me, known as the drip lord I am, I had to come to school looking fresh. I had to think ahead, you know? So I asked my mom for this bottle, this water bottle. She gave me one from her uni days now, so it was blue. I don't know how else to freaking describe it. So I'll pop it up on the screen somewhere. You see it as a type of bottle. I used to hang it on my, what's it called, my belt hole. We used to wear uniform now, so we had dress trousers with belt holes and all that. So I used to hang it on my belt hole. Cause that was drip. In school, sha. In school, that was a dream. Everybody used to hang things off their. What's the thing called? I just said it now. Off their belt hole. Yeah. So it was a dream, obviously. Now, so I wasn't about to go to school not looking fresh. I had to think for the future. Now, there was this guy, right? Two grades above me, and he was in his final class, SS3 or Americans, grade 12th grade, or for my UK guys, I guess 13th, I don't know. But then yeah, you get the gist. He was like 16 or 17. I was like how old was I? I was like 15. Yeah, I was like 15. No, yeah, I was 15. Yeah, I remember I was turning 15. Yes, I was turning 15. He was like already 17, or is he 18? I don't know. Was he a big guy, Sha? So yeah, I don't know what entered this guy's head. I don't know whether he smoked yesterday or he drank something. They gave this man claimed my bottle that I got from home. Keep in mind, bottle that I got from my mom. That she got during her university days. He decided to claim it as his. He said he had this bottle since last term or whatever. I'm like, are you dumb? Well, I didn't even give the guy a name. Let's say his name is Dave. His name is Dave, right? I know Dave. Dave saw me with this bottle and decided to claim it. Because once again, I was a drip lord, you know, everybody saw my drip. Everybody saw my drip. People acknowledged me.
Please clap.
People acknowledge me. So I said this guy tried to claim my bottle. Like, are you daft? Sheesh. But let me tell you that this guy is indeed pussy. Yes, I saw this. Pussy. Because he did not come to me for the bottle. This guy stole the bottle from my locker when I was out in class. If he came, I said I'm 6'10". I would have beaten the guy. The guy didn't want. He had sense at that moment, you know. Because if he came to collect this shit from me, knock the guy out. What are you telling me? What are you talking about? Fine. So this guy stole my bottle, as I said, from my locker. I'm like, oh, he stole my bottle. Fine. So I said, okay, I'll chill. Let me wait for lunchtime to approach the guy. Because just keep in mind, he's still my senior. So, and in Nigeria, seniority. Oh, that's it. None of these students. Respect for your elders, your seniors. It's taking. It's a big thing. I just know it's a big thing. Yeah. So I approached him as calm as possible. I said, Dave, please. This is my bottle. My mom gave me this bottle. This guy was just cussing me out. All the times I went to him, he cussed me out. Even his boys, they were helping him and telling me to get the fuck out or shut the fuck up and leave, you know. And I'm like, okay, it's nothing new that I haven't been through, because like, he's a senior, I'm his junior. Like, it was irregular things because that by his seniors. So it wasn't really new to me. You dig? It wasn't new. But then the thing that pissed me off when I met him the first time for that bottle, this guy had the audacity to put his lips on the bottle. If you want to piss me off, collect my bottle and put your lips on it. Oh. Like that, how can you be that wicked to do such a thing? Like, it's not fair, it's not nice, it's not. I don't read that shit though, I don't read it. So, fine, I still kept my calm now, you know, I still kept my calm because I had to take matters into my own hands, if you might say. So, you know, I took matters into my hands. Fine. Guess what I did? I stole my bottle back.
Oh my god.
Yes. I stole my bottle back. Cause I mean, in his case it was different. He's my senior. So him stealing the bottle makes him look like pussy. But then like me stealing my bottle back, it just gave me, it showed that I was brave, I was daring, you know, I could take risks. Aha, you feel me? I could take risks. I couldn't come to him and collect the bottle. This guy is big. I mean, I'm 6'10", but the guy is still big, you know, and he had his boys who, like, it was one against like seven. It wasn't going to work that way. So I stole my bottle back. I stole my bottle back, you know, and I hid it because I was no way I was going to get that bottle back. For what? Because am I mad? I mean, what are you talking about, bro? What are you talking about? I told this guy my mom gave me this bottle. The guy said no. I've been using this since last time. I just lost it. Wahala be like bicycle, sha. But lo and behold, let me reveal this to you. Lo and behold, I read. This man did not know I had any checkmates. I was about to end his whole career.
To end this man's whole career.
You know, before leaving home, I had put my name on this bottle. I engraved my name on the bottom of this bottle. And he didn't.
Here it is. Boom. Bam. Oh, bop. Bada bop. Boom. Pow. Oh!
That's where I had him in check me again. Who's ready to check me? Because. Do I need to talk more? Do I need to talk? I don't need to talk more. What are you telling me? My name was in the bottle. So when I had to. Before I stole his shirt, I gave him that news. Guy. My name is on that bottle. Look at it. The guy looked at it. He was looking like a fool, like an imbecile in front of his friends. His friends, they didn't have anything to say. What can they say? What can they say? Would they still call me a fool? Rubbish. Dave. It was that day that I knew Dave don't get sense. Dave don't get sense. You understand? Oh yeah, my name was on the bottle, you know. Nothing less had ended his whole career. I was looking like a fool. But believe it or not, yeah, the morning after I stole that bottle, I stole it on a Saturday night. So Sunday morning, I was woken up by him. By a beating, as per. This guy beat me, slapped me, threatened me. When I came to that school, they told me, all the bullies have gone. They have eliminated all. I say eliminated. They have expelled all the bullies. Fine, I was like, okay, I'm safe. So, but why am I still receiving? Why am I still being bullied in SS1? I'm like, what's going on? But I didn't look at it as bullying, though. I didn't look at it as bad. I just looked at it as a minor inconvenience. You get me? So, the guy searched my locker. He searched my room everywhere. Didn't find this bottle because I was too smart. I was too smart. I had to pull off an Oscar performance. Kevin Hart for call me for his next movie. Because I acted like I didn't know where this bottle was. Like the bottle was stolen from both of us. And the guy believed.
Please clap.
The guy. That performance, God, I'm too good now. I'm too good. But yeah, performance was too good, you know. After beating me and threatening me, he left me. I had to let it blow off for like, say, 2 weeks. Yeah, 2 weeks. Fine. That's when I could finally bring my bottle out and use. Cause like, are you dumb? How you going to tell me that I stole the bottle that my mom gave me from her university days? Like, ridiculous. don't embarrass yourself, because.
Are you not ashamed of yourself? Are you not embarrassed? This is really embarrassing.
We're big men. We supposed have sense by now. We're in secondary school. What are you doing? Come to 13 me for why you the lies. I beg Dave don't get sense, sha, but then I think we're good now. Yeah, we're good now. I'll post something on my Instagram and the guy will comment as if nothing happened between us in secondary school, but you're not meant to keep grudges or anything, so we're cool now. We're cool now. But yeah, you know, moral of the story, push through. Don't settle for rubbish. If someone is doing you bad, don't say, okay, do me bad. I am your canvas. Paint on me. What's that? Push through adversities, you know. Do all of that. Don't let them fucking bully you, man. What are you doing? Stand up for yourself. But yeah, that's it, you know. That was the video. I guess that was my first video. Clap for me again.
Please clap.
Cause it has been your boy Jubemin HD. First video things. You know. If you like that, if you enjoyed that story, If you enjoyed that story, please subscribe. Please like the video. Please click your notification bell. You know, comment something nice. Share my video to your friends. Like this video if you love your mom. If you love your mom, like this video. It's not a threat. It's just, it's conditions. If you like your mom, just like this video. It's your business. Don't disappoint your mom. But yeah, it has been your boy Jubemi in HD. Oluwa Jubemi, aka baddest guy ever. Leave it. And I'll see you in the next video. Peace.
Okay, bye.